For savers, 2021 will be another year of damage limitation and trying to get the best rates, not good rates. And that's because several things combine to lower the returns savers can expect to get. First, the Bank of England base rate is at record lows of 0.1%, and there's even been talk it could turn negative. That means you pay the bank to keep your money with them. Base rate is factored into savings rates, so if this stays low, then interest rates on those deals will too. The Bank of England has no obvious reason to raise its rates soon. It wants to get consumers spending money and supporting businesses, not saving. It has also offered high street banks long-term funding at very low rates. That is meant to help businesses and households by encouraging the banks to lend, but it penalises savers. This is because banks have no need to offer enticing savings deals to get consumers to deposit cash with them, which they can then use to lend out. Also, banks are businesses like any other, and COVID-19 has affected them too. Many are running less efficiently than they were and under more financial pressure. That's not an environment likely to generate good savings rates. On top of all this, inflation is set to rise. It is currently 0.7%, but the Bank of England thinks it will rise to 1.8% in 2021, close to its target of 2%. That's a problem because no savings deals currently even pay 1.8%, bar a couple of very restricted current accounts. So sadly, the outlook isn't great for savers, but we should all still keep some cash aside for emergencies. 3 to 6 months of your normal spending in a cash savings account is ideal. The good news is that savers can offset some of the effects of all this by finding the best savings deals. Making your savings work as hard as possible is the sensible thing to do, even if the rates available are not quite what you'd like.